With the upcoming Winter Royale, we know many people are eager to compete and have a chance at millions of dollars worth of prizes and earnings. We'll look no further because this guide is everything you need to prepare for the major event. In this video, we've compiled some of the best ways that you can train and practice in order to perform at your prime during the Winter Royale. Many people won't be practicing and training, and they will only start once the Winter Royale begins. So just by watching this video, you're already at an advantage. But before we dive into the fun, we need to ask you guys, do you want to get better at Fortnite? If the answer is yes, visit ProGuides.com in the description where you can get one-on-one coaching from some of the best players. We also have a ton of content to help you improve from your favorite pros like Benji and Mongrel. So if you want to see a massive improvement, head on over to ProGuides.com. So to start off, critical thinking is a very complex and important skill that you must have if you want to succeed in competitive Fortnite. Doctors, athletes, and just about anyone who's a pro at something has some degree of critical thinking that helped them get there. It just so happens that this skill is very underrated in the esports scene, and it's about time that someone sheds light on it. Critically thinking is the ability to make decisions based on connecting pieces of information that you've gathered, all while doing so in as little time as possible. To help give you a good idea of what it is, let's take a look at a quick example. Let's say that a pro player is in the endgame and they need to rotate. They also happen to be in the midground, aka in between the high ground and low ground. First, this player needs to gather information. Where are the players below and above me located? Are any of them fighting? Are any of them paying attention to me? Is the circle on an area of natural high ground or is it going down? And other questions like that. Once this player has gathered the information, they need to make decisions to dictate their next move. Should they be moving towards high ground or low ground as they rotate? Should they rotate last or first? Should they be looking for opponents to third party if there's people fighting? These decisions need to be solely based off the information they've gathered. This process of thinking and analyzing in order to make your next move will make you improve the fastest way possible. The players that perform the best aren't the ones who are mechanically the best. Instead, they're the ones who are the smartest players and the ones who practice the right things. Critical thinking is the most effective and quickest way to improve your in-game intelligence and decision-making. Next time you go into a game, start paying attention to everything and only make decisions if you have a reason for it. So for example, don't rotate to an area if you don't have a reason for it. And within a short period of time, you will start to learn and master the ability of making the best decisions for the right reasons. This is a process that takes years for pros to learn. This is because they're not actually aware of what they're doing. They naturally do it and learn from their mistakes for years until they finally start doing things right. Now that you understand the concept of critical thinking and how to improve it, you've been given one of the best explanations and tutorials for mastering the most important technique for improving your in-game thinking. So why stress in-game thinking so much? The reason it's so important is because making the right decisions can make a huge difference in endgames and scenarios where you're going to be playing against the best players in the world. If you learn to play smarter instead of harder, you'll be able to avoid getting into unnecessary fights in the first place. Capiche, capashi, get what I'm saying? So now that we've gone over in-game critical thinking, let's move on to some more core aspects of the Winter Royale. Critical thinking is a great skill and absolutely necessary if you want to be consistent and efficient. But you're going to absolutely need to be able to rely on your mechanics at certain times, especially when playing against the best players in box fights. So let's get into how you can improve your box fight skills and go over some of the most important building and editing tricks you need to know when playing in the Winter Royale. You gotta think outside the box! Oh my, you get it? Man, I am funny. All right. Box fights are definitely the most popular form of fighting amongst competitive and professional Fortnite players in this current chapter. Many Fortnite pros resort to box fighting as it's safe and requires great skill in order to win. It's heavily reliant on editing and aiming skills rather than building, which is a big change from the previous seasons that wear heavy on building speed. First and foremost, you'll need to know some basic yet effective edits. These are the best ways to start off with as they're easy to learn, but they are still very useful. First, we have the window edit to instant reset, which is a great trick to throw off skilled opponents. Let's start by going over some really good tips for console players who tend to have a bit of an input delay. These next few tricks are just as good for PC players, but especially useful for those of you on console. Many times when you're in a box fight, you and your opponent will be fighting for control over a wall. This wall is usually the main thing separating the two of you, and whoever controls it has the upper hand. Usually, when you get control of this wall, one of two things happen. Either your opponent places a ramp between and then edits out from the top or the side, or the opponent stands there salivating with their guns out, waiting for you to make an edit. Both of these can occur and both can effectively ruin your chances of actually making a good play against your opponent. More often, however, you'll find that your opponent is attempting to shoot you while you edit. This works effectively for them because you have to wait a half second for your gun to pull out after you make that edit, whereas all your opponent has to do is shoot you and build as soon as you open that wall. Here's the counter to their power play. All you have to do is make a quick window edit or any kind of edit, and then quickly reset the wall so that it becomes a complete barrier before the opponent shoots. What this will do is bring the wall's health down and cause the opponent to break the wall when they really meant to shoot you. This will throw them off and give you a second to shoot back and take advantage of this sneaky move. Man, you sneaky, bro. Good stuff, dude. Do a quick little dab on the haters. Bow. Ooh, that felt good. I'm gonna do bow, bow. Ooh, two dabs? Ooh, too many? No. Dab, dab, dab. Man, I need more dabs in my life, baby. Anyway. Another great editing maneuver is the trap ramp flip, which is very useful if you box in your opponent. More often than not, players will make the mistake of placing traps on the sides of the walls when they box in their opponent. This makes it very easy for them to break the traps and evade taking damage. Instead, place a ramp in between you and your opponent. Then put the trap on the top of the box and flip the ramp in between you so that you're under it. This will expose your opponent to the trap and leave no room for them to actually counter it, making it a simple yet extremely useful tactic for finishing off a fight. You really ramp up the stakes. You ramp up the stakes of the fight. Okay, anyway. Finally, we have a cool spin on a popular move used by many pros such as Mongrel. Many times when pros are playing aggressively in box fights and are extending out into other people's boxes, they will instantly place a ramp inside of their opponent's box and then place a wall in between to take control. What this does is take control of your opponent's cover and the wall in between you. Now, instead of using ramps, we suggest using pyramids. This is because ramps give the opponent cover and it will take you half a second to edit that ramp out, no matter how fast you edit. This is time that the opponent can use to quickly edit out the back and hide into another box. You sneaky dog, get back here. When you use a pyramid, however, the only thing you have to actually edit is the wall and your opponent is completely exposed. Another great thing about pyramids is that you can edit them and manipulate them however you desire, which means you can pull off some pretty awesome and flashy editing tricks on your opponents if you get a pyramid inside of their box. Now that we've gone over some simple box fight tricks, let's go over the more advanced ones. Something that tends to happen a lot when playing against a bunch of high-tier people is that they will tend to have a very low ping. This makes it very hard for you to actually take their walls efficiently. However, there is some in-game tricks you can use to lower this barrier. These do require lots of practice and skill though, so make sure you spend time in creative mastering them. One of the best things you can do in these situations is to use the ramp phase technique, which requires you to utilize a ramp and incredible timing to phase through anyone's walls. How this works is you start by making their wall one pickaxe away from crumbling, whether it's by shooting it or pickaxing it. Next, place a ramp on top of you and jump. While you're in the middle of your jump, you want to swing your pickaxe so that it breaks the wall. The momentum of the ramp pushing you forward with the jump will phase you through their wall even if they have zero ping. This only happens when you time it perfectly though, so make sure you're really practicing. We're talking about practice, not the game, practice. Also, keep in mind that the timing for this move will vary for console and PC because of the input delay. So make sure you're trying out the timing different ways to ensure that you're learning it the right way for your specific circumstance. So we've gone over the two most important things for dominating in the Winner Royale, intelligence and box fight mechanics. But let's talk a little bit about how you can actually practice these as effectively as possible, specifically for the Winner Royale. Your routine for practicing every single day should always start with a mechanical warm-up. This means you're practicing your building, editing, and aiming. The best way to do this is by jumping into a creative lobby with some of your friends and running 1v1s until you feel like you're adjusted with the game. We're talking about practice. It is also very important to practice specific moves that you plan on using during the box fights. Some of these moves should be the ones we talked about during this video. Practice these by going through the motions and really making them muscle memory to the point where you can do them on opponents without having to put too much thought into it. This, my friends, is a great level to be at. It is the pro level. Pros are doing this way before they even compete in events. Next, you're going to practice your in-game decision-making skills, or critical thinking skills as we like to call it. The way you should do this is by hopping into real arena games and practicing playing and surviving until the end game. The way you'll know you're getting better at playing intelligently is by seeing if you're placing higher more consistently. The farther you can get in your games while doing it almost every game is the best way to track your progress for critical thinking skills. Look at you, bro, thinking! Oh, I'm proud of you, man! Do you like critical thinking and making it to end game? I am thinking so much and I don't know the words. All right, well, let's just get back on topic. Keep practicing these by working on your decision making and highlighting your mistakes so that your judgment improves the next time around. Sooner or later, you'll be making little to no mistakes, and you'll be finishing at the top of every lobby. Alright guys, that's it for today's video. We hope you enjoyed. Comment down below what you thought and what you'd like to see next. We strive to bring you guys daily quality content, so do us a favor by liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and show ProGuides.com some love for bringing you to this video. Thanks for watching. Once again, it's your host, Cody. You can follow me on Instagram at Coco Medler. Are you cuckoo for the cocoa? Let me know, my friends, my pimps, my dudes, my dudettes, everybody, y'all. I'll see you on the next one. Do you like critical thinking? Man, that was a good song.